Good morning, students. Yesterday we started our next topic, that is physical and chemical change. And in the introduction part, what exactly physical change that we learned yesterday? Okay. So physical change means what? The change occurs in their physical properties. Now physical properties, shape, size, color, states. Okay. The change occur in these all physical properties. And no new substance is formed. That is only known as a physical change. With this introduction part, yesterday we discussed. So today, what exactly the physical change and which properties of physical change that we are going to discuss now. See here, I written a definition. This definition, it is given in your textbook. Okay, just read a textbook. What is definition? See, a change in which only the physical properties, see here, a change in which only the physical properties of any substance will change and no new substance is formed. See, this one is very important. Means whenever the changes occur, now so many changes occur in our surrounding, but which are physical change, which are chemical change, that we have to identify. Okay, and how we will identify that? Because of their particular characteristics. Okay, so what the exactly physical change? The change occur in their physical properties of a substance and no new substance is formed. See, there is physical change, there will no new substance will form and is called as a physical change. So for example, melting of ice. Now melting of ice, then you will say, madam, after melting of ice we will get the water, so here new substance formed. But no, see, first what water only it was there. When we keep that water in a freezer, the 0 degree Celsius, water converted into ice, the properties are remain same. There is no any change, only the change in their states. Okay, now how, see, first water, okay, water is in which state? Liquid state. After, when you keep in a freezer, this water converted into ice. Now ice which state? Solid state. Okay, and this when ice melted, again it converted into water after melting. Okay, so again you will get a liquid, and the same liquid, if you will provide a heat, see, if you will provide heat, then this water will convert into water vapors. And water vapors is in which state? Gas state. Okay, see here. So these all the changes occurs, okay, but these all the changes occurs in their physical properties. Means see here, now first water, so water is in a liquid state. Okay, when you keep it in a freezer, this water is converted into ice, means it will convert into which state? Solid state. Again after the condensation process, means after this, outside, then this ice will convert into a liquid state, and then if you will provide heat to that water, then again it will convert it into a water vapors, means what? Gaseous state. So here size change, shape change and state change. Okay, but the chemical properties, whatever the chemical composition remains same, and here no any new substance is formed. So this is one example of physical change. Do you understand the physical change? Okay, I will revise once again. See, physical change means what? A change in which only the physical properties of any substance get changed and no new substance is formed is called physical change. We just, you have to remember that in physical change, the change occur in physical properties. Now, physical properties, shape, size, color, states. These are all our physical properties. The change occur maybe in shape, maybe in size, maybe in color. Okay. But and in these, no new substance is formed. Such types of change are known as a physical change. Okay, here I given one example how the change occur. This is one example of physical change. Now stretching rubber, this is also one example of physical change. Okay, there are many examples. Melting of wax. Now wax, you know, candle. Okay, see a candle, they whenever the candle burning, so that time the nearby wax, it start melted, but after some times it solidified again. Okay, means what? Again that wax solidify, it convert into water in the liquid, but after some times it again solidify. Means here any new substance is a form? No. So this is also one example of physical change. Okay. So now we will see a characteristics of physical changes. See, characteristics of physical change means what happened? What are the characteristics of physical change? How we will identify these changes is a physical change only. So for that, we should know the definition as well as the characteristics. Okay. See, maybe the question in your exam also we will ask. I will ask you the questions, means identify which are the physical changes. I'll give some examples and then you have to identify this is physical or chemical change. Okay. So now we will learn about characteristics of physical changes. So see, the first one, during a physical change, only physical properties such as, see here, the same, whatever we learn here, the same characteristics also the same. See, during a physical change, only physical properties such as size, shape, color and states change. Okay. And the second one, see a second one, physical change is a reversible change. Now physical change, reversible, irreversible change, and 6th standard we learn already changes around us lesson. If you have 6th standard textbook, just read it again. In that changes, reversible and irreversible changes we learn. Okay, physical change means what? It is a reversible change. Means we will get the original substance back. Okay, or reversible means it occurs again and again. It is a reverse process. So it is a reversible change, and chemical composition of a substance remains same. Means whatever the chemical properties of that particular substance, it remains same. There will be or no change in the chemical properties. Then only it is a physical change. Okay. Now when the chemical properties will change, if the chemical change, then chemical properties will change. Means physical as well as chemical properties will also change. Okay. So do you understand a physical change? So today you read related to this topic, this lesson, it is given in your textbook. Read all the points, as well as if you have a 6th standard textbook, just read reversible and irreversible change, and at least write 10 examples of physical change. How many examples you will write? 10 examples of physical change. Okay, so tomorrow we will discuss about the next point. Okay, so thank you.